Airports are not islands in themselves. They work with a wide variety of stakeholders and people who move in and out of the airport.
As an airport, you need to look at climate change, how it's going to affect your business in terms of risk and continuity. But at the same time, of course, that means you need to contribute to fighting climate change by reducing your own carbon emissions.
In 2016, Oslo Airport became the first airport in the world to supply sustainable aviation fuel to all airlines refueling at our airport. So we've taken some camelina oil from an EU project, and we've also actually imported biofuels from California based on used cooking oil, so waste products. So the carbon footprint of that fuel is very favorable compared with the dirty fossil fuel.
We have this process called airport collaboration decision making, where actually all the actors that use the airport have to give data to the airport, and that allows to reduce disruptions, to make more efficiency in the way the airports operate, and that translates into less CO2 emissions.
Passengers that come to our airport can have a climate impact through either taking public transport or driving, if they have an electric car, driving that to our airport and using our car charging stations. They can also help with the recycling of their waste, and they can avail themselves of carbon offsetting schemes through their own airline.
An airport has a responsibility to society. It provides a number of economic benefits, but it also has a responsibility to ensure that its environmental impact is as small as possible.